Hello, I am C.J. Seitz, Chief Justice of the Delaware Supreme Court. I want to speak with you about jury service in the Delaware courts during the time of COVID-19. Jury service is fundamental to our democracy. The United States Constitution guarantees the right to a jury trial in criminal cases. It is one of our justice system's most important responsibilities to summon juries to decide criminal and civil matters involving Delaware citizens and people around the world. The Delaware courts have responded to COVID-19 by changing how we conduct jury trials. We reviewed our processes from the first contact with you, a jury summons, all the way to the end of the process when we thank you for your service to the state. At every step, our goal was to make sure that you are as safe and protected as possible by following recommendations from state and national health experts. We also hired our own Delaware infectious disease expert to provide advice along the way. Our revised jury service guidelines, which you are about to hear, are the result of hundreds of hours of study by judges, lawyers, and experts. We are confident that they are the best and safest of any state. What you will see when you act as a jury are screening at the courthouse doors, people wearing masks and plastic shields over the mouth and nose, social distancing, enhanced cleaning and sanitation procedures, and changes in the courtroom to keep everyone safe. On behalf of the judges, lawyers, and employees who make up our Delaware justice system, thank you for your attention to the details you are about to hear. Most of all, thank you again for doing your part under the United States Constitution and our state constitution to serve as a juror in our system of justice.
During this pandemic, the Delaware courts have taken significant steps to protect your health safety as a juror. First is our updated juror questionnaire. It has been expanded to specifically address COVID-19 issues, including potential exposure and employment issues related to the pandemic. You can mail back your completed questionnaire, but an even better way to complete it is to fill it out online at courts.delaware.gov/juror, saving both you and court staff time. Responses to excusal requests submitted online are usually sent within one business day. Responses to questionnaires that are mailed in could take more than a week. If you fill out the questionnaire online, you are also able to see the status of your request for an excusal when you log back into that page. Whether you fill out the questionnaire online or return it by mail, it is important that you fill it out in advance. The information collected in the questionnaire is a critical part of the jury selection process. We want to make sure that you do not have to make an unnecessary trip to the courthouse if you are going to be excused. Next, there have been significant changes at our courthouses due to the pandemic. New cleaning and disinfecting procedures have been put in place, with a particular focus on frequent cleaning of high-contact areas like railings, door handles, and elevator buttons. Everyone is required to wear a mask that covers their face and nose while inside our courthouses. Social distancing markers have been installed both inside and outside our courthouses to help make sure everyone keeps a safe distance apart. A number of signs have also been posted inside as an additional reminder to visitors to practice social distancing and wear a mask. Plexiglass shields have been installed in areas where the public interact with staff and in the courtrooms as an additional layer of protection. Upon entering the courthouse, all visitors must pass a COVID-19 screening and temperature check conducted by Capitol Police. If you're experiencing any symptoms related to COVID-19 or believe you have been exposed within 14 days prior to your jury service, please do not go to the courthouse. Instead, please contact jury services to let them know of the situation. Inside the courthouse, hand sanitizer is available at a number of locations, but you may also bring a small container of your own hand sanitizer if you wish. Finally, the entire jury process was redesigned to reduce or eliminate the need to stand in lines or gather in large groups. For example, in the jury assembly room in the Leonard Williams Justice Center, some 200 chairs were removed and the remaining 60 chairs were rearranged so that each prospective juror has a radius of at least 6 feet around them. Once you are in your designated chair, rather than have to stand in line to check in, a jury services staffer will come to you to complete the check-in process. Finally, instead of moving large numbers of jurors from place to place during the selection process, in many instances, video technology will now be used to allow the judge to communicate with jurors in the jury assembly room during the selection process. Some things about jury service will remain the same as before the pandemic. There are certain things that are not allowed in the courthouse and should be left at home. Jurors driving to the Leonard L. Williams Justice Center can park at the attached garage. If you park in the garage, please bring your parking stub with you, as Superior Court has a limited number of free parking spaces and may be able to validate your parking. If the number of free spaces has been exhausted, the cost will be $11 a day. The courthouse is also served by a number of DART bus lines. Please consult the DART website for additional information at dartfirststate.com. Once through the security screening at the main entrance of the Leonard Williams Justice Center, please travel down the hall to the right and follow signs for jury services, where you'll be directed to take a seat in the jury assembly room. Separate bathroom facilities and vending machines are available in jury services for your convenience. Once everyone has been checked in, the orientation process will begin, followed by the jury selection itself. This process may involve the judge asking you certain questions to ensure that you do not have any conflicts or issues serving on the case to be tried. A juror information sheet and a list of frequently asked questions has also been created to assist you and is available on the same page where you found this video. We thank you for taking the time to watch this video and for helping the Delaware Court ensure the right to a jury trial. Your participation is central to our justice system, and we appreciate your service.